Look, let me tell you about a kid named Steven. Slowly running out of things to believe in. Every couple of months his mom leaves him for no good reason. His stepdad beats him. That's when many friends only ever had a few of them. But recently they don't want anything to do with him. Always eating lunch in the bathroom star. He just wants to feel normal and be cool again. Yeah, always feeling like the outcast. He's been going crazy ever since his dad passed. He needs guidance in a place, but instead he only has breakdowns and flashbacks to the car crash. It's been getting harder every day. If he was still around, everything would be okay. Cause his dad was always the light at the end of the tunnel, but now the same damn tunnel looking dark and gray. He's quiet in the back of the class, and when the bell rings, Steven hurries so fast. He's scared to death the other kids will kick his ass on the long walk home, cause it's happened in the past. So he's getting used to the black eyes and fat lips. A lot of guys have a fake smile and cut wrists, wishing he could walk right up to him, showing his scars. Hey, look, you're the reason that I've done this. Maybe they will finally understand and go back to how it was before it all began. But he's just a little different, so they call him and they beat him. Yeah, it's called his funny games, they don't give a damn. Yeah, his older brother ain't around. In and out of jail, hanging with the bunk rap. He's been doing coke, smoking weed, getting drunk all his life. He's ashamed, no, he's not too proud. Now his habits are rubbing off on his little bro. Yeah, but guess what? Little did he know that every time he did a lie, every time he lit a joint, every time he took a shot, he was in the mode. So Steven's sitting in his room, getting high now. Doors locked, music up, on the lights out. He just takes another toke till the rules for the smoke. 5, 6, 7 hours till he knocks out. Now he's starting to steal pills from his mom. 8, 9, 10 at a time, and now they're gone. And maybe for the moment, all his problems seem to fade. But they're hot face too, after not too long. And that's when it really sticks in, that's when it hits him. That he's got there, trucks won't fix him. Curled up on the floor, can't take it anymore. Now he's talking to God, cause he's the only one that hits him. On his knees, looking up, can't stop crying. Gotta know we haven't talked in a long time. But this time I really need you. Please, God, help me, say something, just give me a sign. Cause now I'm falling apart, and now I think that I can do it. Please, God, give me the strength to pull through it. Tell me, should I give up? I can't end it all right now. I just don't know if I'm brave enough to do it. Cause there's gotta be a better way than suicide. Try to wait it out, give it time, you'll be fine. But it's been so long, and I still haven't been able to get rid of all the thoughts that I'm feeling sad. So sick, so angry, so mad. And to top it off, no one even knows that. That's why he stood up, wiped his tears, walked over to his desk, and got a pen and a notepad. He just couldn't see it getting any better. He picked one I called up night in December. Doesn't even know exactly what he had to do. But first he sat down, wrote a couple letters. One to his stepdad, one to his mother. Couple to the kids at school, one to his brother. Bringing them the pain that they once brought him. Teardrops on the paper, one after another. Yeah, I hope that you all feel guilty. Cause I'm broken now and you can't heal me. And now you're all an accomplice of murder. Each and every one of you are tricked in to kill me. So the reason that I'm waiting you this evening is to sympathize, tell you that I'm leaving. But don't hold your breath, cause I ain't never coming back. Sincerely yours, Lucy. Make some noise.